Hello, darlings. I am Cassandra. Welcome to the Daily Inspirational Oracle Reading. If you have a problem, issue, concern, and perhaps you're looking for a sign, or maybe a different perspective, or just another way of looking at it, darling, perhaps this reading can resonate with your spirit, or you may simply allow your mind to settle within your heart and let whatever issues or concerns you have surface from your subconscious mind and let it resonate with this reading. The first card I have for you today, darling, is from Jungle Beauty Goddess Sinai. And Jungle Beauty Goddess Sinai's message to you today is, take a risk. She represents our second chakra. We'll talk about that in just a second. Let me give you your three cards. The next card I have for you is, again, we're pulling in Sinai's second chakra energy. And her message to you today is, no regrets ever, which ties right into the last card I have for you today. It's from Jungle Beauty Goddess Namib, darling, who represents our crown chakra, our relationship with our higher self and our guides and our, our guardian angels. Her message to you is, let it go. Some things are not meant to be known. So, let's just get into this, guys. So, listen, whatever has happened to you in the past, whether it's on your job or a relationship, the universe is asking you to let it go. Did that person rat on you? Doesn't matter. Did he cheat or did she cheat? Who cares? Let it go, because some things are not meant to be known, because no regrets ever. So basically, Jungle Beauty Goddess Sinai represents your second chakra, which is 2 inches below your navel. And this chakra is responsible for your pleasure, your joy, the sensuousness of your life, darling, your taste buds. So if you eat, anything and you're just like, oh my God, this is so delicious, or it's just any of your five senses, when they appreciate the beauty of the world, that is your second chakra. So if you look at a picture and you think, oh my God, it was so beautiful, it took my breath away, that's your second chakra. That's your pleasure center. Okay. It's a place that's responsible for joy and just enjoying your life. But it is also responsible for your relationships with other people. Like your best friends. Is it a codependent relationship? Is it a healthy relationship? And it's responsible for your creativity. Oh my God. When you write a song, draw a picture, whenever you do anything creative, we're talking 2 inches below your navel, darling. Yes, we're talking your second chakra. And the element for your second chakra is water, okay? Now water, child, that is ruled by the moon. You know the moon ties and the water ties and it all flows together. And it's also responsible for your emotions. So the word for your second chakra is I feel. Now, what this reading today is asking you to do, it is asking you to cleanse any past pain, past worry, anything that has happened in the past. The universe is asking you to let it go. And one of the things that cleanses our soul is water. So I'm going to tell you that you should somehow immerse yourself in the element of water. You can invest in like a really inexpensive water fountain. I love the sound of a good water fountain. It cleanses my mind, and just listen to it and let it cleanse and clear your mind. You may take a nice salt bath. If you don't, just put some sea salt in your, just a little bit, you need a lot. Half a cup in your bath water and allow it to cleanse your body from toxins, from negative energy, from past mistakes. Because remember, let it go. You don't need to know what happened. No regrets ever. Because you're not going to be able to take a risk. See, if your energy in your second chakra is blocked, You're not going to be able to recognize that new relationship, that new opportunity. You're not going to be able to receive the overflowing abundance of love, of prosperity, of gifts, of happiness, of joy, of pleasure. You're not going to be able to receive any of those things until you are able to let go of the past and just and say, hey, no regrets. No regrets ever, darling. Right? So what, you love that boy? Yeah, we've all had our heart broken, right? So what, you took this job and it turned out to be a nightmare. So, you know, it made you stronger, right? Everything. So the universe is telling you to please cleanse your mind, your body, and your soul. The best way to do it is with water. A nice, like I said, a salt bath, a shower, any listening to the sound of rain, even drinking water, and with intention. So you know how you can. One of the things you can do is drink like some type of spring water, distilled water, but you know, just even if it's water from your fountain, you just want to bless it, you want to cleanse it. And you want to say to the water, because water holds energy, as I drink this water, it cleanses my mind, body, and soul. As I cleanse this, all things from the past are now released. When you take your shower, just take your, you know, when the water comes down, just have the intention of letting go of the past, letting go of past hurts, last mistakes, any patterns of disappointment. Like, you know, sometimes people have a pattern where they always trust the wrong people, y'all. Let it go, because if you don't let it go, then you won't know what a new friend is in your life, or somebody you can trust, right? So today's message from the universe is all about letting go of the past, so that you, my darling, are able to take a risk, because you want to be able to take a risk on something new, a new opportunity, a new job. You want to accept the overflowing abundance of opportunities that are going to come into your life, but in order to do that, you must first release the past. I really hope this reading helps someone. Thank you so much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you, darling, in the next video.